Growing up in Kansas City, you don't expect to have someone in your neighborhood who is an artist whose work is known all around the world. But my neighbor, Charles Barsotti, was a cartoonist, and during his long career, he did thousands of cartoons and other drawings that appeared in places like The New Yorker, The Saturday Evening Post, USA Today, Playboy, The Atlantic, and The New York Times. Charles Barsotti passed away a few years ago. His wife, Ray Barsotti, showed me around his studio and shared some memories of him. How did he get started as a cartoonist?
Well, he got started, he was drawing cartoons when he was a young boy. And he always kind of wanted to do that. And then in college, there was a college paper and he drew cartoons for the paper.
Charles served in the Army and then worked at a school for children with special needs.
The head of the school took him on a trip to New York and he took some cartoons. And then he just went around and went into the New Yorker and he sold one. And he was, that was the beginning. And of course the New Yorker to him was like, I always say he loved the New Yorker. It was like, because it just meant a lot to him. He loved the magazine. So that started it. And then he from there went to Hallmark. He decided to come up here. And then from here he got the call from the Saturday Evening Post. After he sent them some drawings, they wanted him to come and be the cartoon editor.
Charles also did a newspaper comic strip called Sally Bananas.
It was a strip about a young girl and her life, funny things that happened to her.
Would the magazines tell him what they wanted the cartoons to be about?
No, he would sit and he would get the idea, and he'd sit down at the drawing board, and he would pencil it in, and then eventually ink it in. And it was just whatever, it might be something current that was in politics, it might be his dog cartoons, whatever. But he did what he wanted to do, and then hoped they would buy it.
How did you meet Charles?
Well, I met Charles through my brother. He called one day and said that I ought to come over because they were having a pool party at his girlfriend's house and that Charlie Barsotti was there and that I ought to come over and meet him. And so I said, no, I'm cooking a pot roast, not coming. And then after I hung up, I decided I'd turn the pot roast off. And I went over there and I met Charlie and we kind of hit it off, and he invited me out for coffee, and the rest is history. We started dating, and it got married.
Barsotti's cartoons appeared in books, in advertising, on things like calendars and mugs, and even on British postage stamps. Sandy Midkiff, who is a judge here in Kansas City, was a close friend of the Barsottis. What do you like most about his cartoons?
Some of my favorites are the cartoons that Charlie has given me over the years that are hanging on my kitchen wall here. And, you know, of course, he's a great lover of dogs and cats, and he has this way of capturing the character of dogs and cats.
Of all the cartoons he did, is there one that was your favorite?
Well, I always kind of liked that last one he did. Because of my hair.
What do you remember most about Charles?
Well, I think he loved his work. I think he loved drawing cartoons, and it was a lot of good times, and all went by too fast. It's getting later than you think, somebody said the other day, and I think that's true.